Hi, I'm Swarupa Sai, course instructor for fluid mechanics. In this presentation, we will go through the surface tension for liquid droplet and bubble, and we will solve problems based on it. When a liquid surface is plane, the forces due to surface tension T act tangentially to the liquid surface in opposite directions. Hence, the resultant force on the molecule is zero because one is acting in positive x direction and the other one is acting in negative x direction. Therefore, in case of a plane liquid surface, the pressure on the liquid side is equal to the pressure on the vapor side. That is, inside pressure is equal to the pressure which is outside. But when the surface of the liquid is curved, there is a difference in pressure between inner and outside surface. When liquid surface is curved, every molecule on the liquid surface experiences forces due to surface tension along the tangent to the surface. And when we resolve this tangential force into horizontal and vertical components, we find that horizontal components cancel out each other as they are acting in opposite directions, while vertical components get added up. Therefore, resultant force normal to the surface acts on the curved surface of the liquid. Similarly, for a convex surface, the resultant force is directed inwards towards the center of curvature, whereas the resultant force is directed outwards from the center of curvature for a concave surface. Thus, for a curved liquid surface in equilibrium, the pressure on its concave side is greater than the pressure on its convex side. The excess pressure inside a bubble and a liquid drop. Small bubbles and liquid drops are spherical because of the forces of surface tension. A bubble or liquid drop does not collapse because pressure inside the bubble or a drop is greater than the pressure surrounding it. Now we will find out surface tension on liquid droplet. This is a liquid droplet of diameter D. And this droplet is formed due to surface tension sigma. The tensile force due to surface tension is acting on the entire surface of the droplet. The surface membrane of the droplet wants to get in, but it gets cancelled by inside excess pressure, that is P. So, P is equal to pressure inside the droplet above outside pressure. Sigma is the surface tension of the liquid and D is equal to diameter of the droplet. Surface tension force acting around the circumference is equal to sigma, that is surface tension, into pi D. Pi D is circumference. And the pressure force F is equal to P into A. We know that pressure is equal to force by area. So, pressure force F is equal to pressure into area. So, P as it is and A is area of the droplet, that is equal to pi by 4 d square. And let us name this as equation 2. Under equilibrium condition, both these forces have to be equal and opposite. So, we will equate equation 1 and 2. We get P into pi by 4 d square is equal to sigma into pi d. So, P can be written as P is equal to sigma into pi d divided by area, that is pi by 4 d square. So, we get final equation as P is equal to 4 sigma by D. Let us name this as equation number 9. From this relation, we can conclude that with increase in size of droplet, that is diameter of the droplet, the pressure intensity decreases. That is because P is inversely proportional to D. That means when D increases, P reduces. Pressure inside the droplet above outside pressure is given by P, which is equal to pressure inside the droplet, which is denoted by Pi, minus pressure outside the droplet, which is denoted by P naught. So, if we want to find pressure inside the droplet, that is Pi, which will be equal to P plus pressure outside the droplet. So, we will name this as equation 10. Now, we will find out surface tension in a soap bubble. A soap bubble is a hollow bubble in which air has two surfaces in contact with bubble. One will be inside and the other outside. Pressure force inside the soap bubble is given as F is equal to pressure into area. So, it will be equal to P into pi by 4 d square if we consider d as the diameter of the bubble. Since there are two surfaces, surface tension on the both sides of the bubble is equal to 2 into sigma, that is surface tension, into pi into d, that is circumference. We will equation 1 and 2, we get P into pi by 4 d square will be equal to 2 into sigma into pi d. So, P is equal to 2 sigma pi d divided by area. So, we get final equation as P is equal to 8 sigma by d. Let us name this as equation number 11. We'll solve a simple problem based on bubble. Find the surface tension in a soap bubble of 40 mm diameter when the inside pressure is 2.5 Newton per square meter above atmospheric pressure. To begin with, write down given data. Diameter of the bubble is given as 40 mm. Convert it into meters. So, 40 into 10 raised to minus 3 meter. Next data given is pressure, which is equal to 2.5 Newton per square meter. With these two data, we need to find out what is surface tension. The formula to find P is given as P is equal to 8 sigma by D. But in this problem, we need to find surface tension, that is sigma. So, sigma will be equal to P into D divided by 8. So, pressure is 2.5, diameter is 40 into 10 raised to minus 3 divided by 8 will give us surface tension as 0.0125 Newton per meter. So, this equation is used for a soap bubble, that is P is equal to 8 sigma by D. If it's a droplet, then it will change. In this problem, the pressure outside the droplet of water of diameter 0.04 mm is given as 10.32 Newton per centimeter square, which is the atmospheric pressure. We need to find the pressure within the droplet if the surface tension is 0.0725 Newton per meter of water. Let us write down the given data. To begin with, diameter D is 0.04 mm. Let us convert it into meter. So, it is 0.04 into 10 raised to minus 3 meter. Outside pressure is P naught, which is equal to 10.32 Newton per centimeter square. So, after conversion, we get it as 10.32 into 10 raised to 4 Newton per square meter. surface tension, that is sigma, is equal to 0.0725 newton per meter. With these data, we need to find out pressure within the droplet, that is PI. Pressure inside the droplet PI is equal to P plus pressure outside the droplet. We have the equation for P. P is equal to 4 sigma by D for droplet plus 10.32 into 10 raised to 4 is pressure outside the droplet. So substitute values of sigma. 4 into sigma is 0.0725 divided by diameter D, that is 0.04 into 10 raised to minus 3 plus 10.32 into 10 raised to 4. So we get PI as 110450 newton per square meter. Thank you.